You're watching Tag TV.
Hello viewers, welcome to Newsweek South Asia, a program that talks about breeding of terrorism and its impact on South Asian nations. Let's begin with the headlines first. Pakistan stays in grey list of FATF, asked to take credible action against terror funding. Al-Qaeda exposes Pakistan military's intimacy with terrorist groups. Deadly blast kills several people in Quetta. And Indian security forces eliminate three Hizbul terrorists from Kashmir. Failing to impress FATF with the pseudo steps of combating terror financing, Pakistan has once again been destined to stay in the grey list of FATF. Its failure in curbing terror funding and hence terrorism has repeatedly frustrated the counter-terrorism efforts of agencies and countries trying to get rid of this menace. The decision of sustaining Pakistan into grey list comes in the wake of Pakistan's unfulfilled commitments at FATF and its non-compliance on its recommendations. We have a detailed report.
Financial Action Task Force held its first review meeting of 2020 from 16 to 21st of this month, where it discussed Pakistan's compliance on its recommendations to curb terror financing. Although the countries keep getting named into the blacklist owing to its hawkish relations with China, Turkey and Malaysia, it could not manage to get relief from the embarrassing grey list. But also in an unexpected shift in China's position, which has always backed Pakistan at the FATF, Beijing sent a stern message to Pakistan to complete its commitments on action against terrorist financing. The International Cooperation Review Group, or ICRG, a subgroup of the Financial Action Task Force, did a complete evaluation of performance of Pakistan during its meeting in Paris, which concluded on 21st of February.
Pakistan was put into grey list in June 2018 and was given time till October 2019 to complete the 27 action points. Now the problem is that 4 months have elapsed from October 2019 and Pakistan has not been able to perform its responsibility in a responsible manner.
Call it Islamabad's poor fate or its negligence, this time again the country faced major humiliation as two of its dreaded terrorists were reported missing from Pakistan's safe custody. First, Taliban leader Ehsanullah Ehsan and later Jaish-e-Mohammed chief Masood Azhar both have been found missing from Pakistan as confirmed by the authorities themselves. However, intelligence input suggests that Masood Azhar has been taken to a secure location by the Pakistani Army and ISI so that no FIR can be registered against him during the FATF meeting and the government cannot be held responsible for not taking any concrete action against him.
Hafiz Saeed gets arrested whenever there is a FATF meeting or there is a pressure on Pakistan. The moment pressure is off, Pakistan releases Hafiz Saeed. So, Pakistan cannot go against terrorists. So these two terrorists who have gone into hiding, they must have gone into Pakistan army custody in a secret on a secret place, and therefore it is very clear that the moment today the FATF decision has been taken, soon you will find these two terrorists emerging out of this black hole. So therefore I think it is the mischief on the part of Pakistan army and Pakistan ISI.
The Paris-based Financial Action Task Force, which reviewed reports from Pakistan on the action taken to curb terror financing by Prime Minister Imran Khan, found many gaps in Pakistan's delivery of its 27-point pledge. The FATF noted that Pakistan has implemented only 14 of the 27 recommendations of FATF on the country's anti-money laundering and combating financing of terrorism mechanism. Pakistan's less than impressive record on conviction and prosecution of top leaders of terror groups was one of the 13 points that the FATF has faulted Islamabad for. Following its observation, the terror financing watchdog asked Pakistan to further tighten its laws to bring individuals involved in money laundering and terror financing to task.
Pakistan cannot take any action against terrorists. Pakistan considers terrorists as their asset. General Musharraf is on record to say that they are our national heroes. So when the terrorists are national heroes, how can you take action against their national, your own national hero? Pakistan cannot. It's all duplicity, all clever maneuvering, all positioning, all propaganda by Pakistan to say that they want to go against and they want to act, they are acting against terrorism. They cannot. They are helpless. Pakistan uses terrorists as an instrument for destabilizing India. How can they punish terrorists?
Despite the eyewash of Hafiz Saeed's sentencing, days ahead of the meeting of Financial Action Task Force, it is of major significance that Pakistan continues to be on the financial watchdog's grey list. Pakistan, which has over 40 terror groups, had attempted to showcase the conviction of Jamaat-ud-Dawah chief Hafiz Saeed as a reflection of its commitment to act against terror. But it had to face hard questions about other global terrorists, including Maulana Masood Azhar, chief of the proscribed Jaish-e-Mohammed, and Dawood Ibrahim, who is sheltered by its establishment.
Pakistan will not be able to get any aid, be it from International Monetary Fund, World Bank, or European Union. So therefore, and that is going to hit Pakistan economically. Pakistan's economy is already in disarray. It is in shambles. Pakistan is not able to pay its own employees, pay allowances for many, many months. Pakistan is in such a crisis situation that economically it is going to be collapsing any time. It is a failed state. So that is the impact of putting Pakistan into grey list.
The FATF, in very strong words, asked Pakistan to swiftly complete its full action plan by June 2020 and warned that FATF could blacklist Pakistan if it does not make significant and sustainable progress, especially in penalizing terror financing. FATF's warning sent a clear message to Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan's government that Islamabad must take urgent, credible, verifiable, irreversible and sustainable steps to effectively implement the FATF action plan. Moreover, the country should also address global concerns related to terrorism and terrorist financing emanating from territory under its control. Islamabad has been on the FATF's grey list since June 2018, making it harder for Imran Khan government to access international markets at a time when the country's economy has been faltering.
Pakistan military establishment and its notorious spy agency, ISI, are known for their intimacy with terror organizations. While many instances in the past speak about their corrupt relationship with terrorist training camps, a latest revelation by the terror group Al-Qaeda about a former Pakistani general, Shahid Aziz, and his connection with Islamic State and Al-Qaeda has brought new highlights into the bonding between terrorists and Pakistan military establishment. A report.
Shahid Aziz, a former general of Pakistan Army and a senior official of ISI, shared close ties with Al-Qaeda and had joined the ISIS in Afghanistan. The announcement about the ISI officer's allegiance with the terror groups has been made by a subgroup of Al-Qaeda in the February edition of its Urdu-language magazine, Nawai Afghan Jihad. After joining militancy post-retirement, Shahid Aziz was reported dead in the year 2018.
Pakistan Army's support to terrorism is very well known. The only people who are denying it is the Pakistan Army and the Pakistan government itself. Otherwise, all the entire world and the world powers, they know that there is a very strong connection between Al-Qaeda and Pakistan, ISI and Pakistan government too.
Pakistani Army's intimate association with terror groups is not an unfamiliar subject to the world. The state organ has always been funding and backing radical Islamic terrorist organizations to to create chaos in Indian subcontinent and the West. Evidences of high-ranking Pakistani state officials engaging into maturing relations with terrorists have often appeared in public sphere. Most recently, pictures and videos of Pakistan's Major General Asif Ghafoor were doing rounds on social media when Pakistan's Director General of ISPR visited Jamia Rashidia Mosque, which shares links with Jaish-e-Mohammed, the terror group responsible for 2019 Pulwama terror attack.
It is no surprise to find that Asif Ghafoor visits a mosque run by Jaish. What is happening is basically these meetings between the top brass of the Pakistan Army and the Jaish militants and others usually takes place in mosques and other such places disguised as where they are going to pray, but inside they sit down and chalk out their programs. Therefore, what is now required by the world powers and the United Nations, already a resolution was moved by the countries, the countries to blacklist Pakistan and to call it terrorist state, but China intervened and stopped that. Now what is required is a push is required to declare Pakistan a terrorist state so that action can be taken against all these terrorist groups that are there.
Former Pakistan President Pervez Musharraf in an interview had also admitted that terrorists are trained in Pakistan by the army as Mujahideen. He even hailed Osama bin Laden, Emmanuel Zawahiri, Jalaluddin Haqqani and jihadi terrorists as Pakistan's heroes. This revelation by General Musharraf is nothing but a proof of Pakistan Army's relentless efforts to accomplish its ambitions of subverting peace and harmony in Indian subcontinent and the rest of the world.
हम मुजाहिदीन लाए पूरी दुनिया से, हमने तालिबान को ट्रेन किया, उन्हें वेपन्स दिए, उनको अंदर भेजा, वो हमारे हीरो थे। ये जो हक्कानी है, हीरो है हमारा जी, इसका हीरो है। ओसामा बिन लादेन हमारा हीरो, उनकी बिल्कुल ट्रेनिंग भी होती थी और हम उनके सपोर्ट में थे कि ये मुजाहिदीन हैं जो इंडियन आर्मी से लड़ेंगे अपने हकूक के लिए। यहाँ फिर ये लश्कर ए तैयबा वगैरह बनी, बहुत सी 10-12 और भी बनी, वो हमारे हीरो थे जी।
पाकिस्तान मिलिट्री एस्टैब्लिशमेंट हैज नेवर बीन एबल टू डिस्चार्ज देमसेल्व्स फ्रॉम द एक्यूजेशन ऑफ हैविंग क्लोज टाइज विद टेरर ग्रुप्स. Since 1947, the uniformed men of Pakistan are using terrorism as a state policy to subvert the voices of dissent inside Pakistan and to raise proxy war against India to illegally gain control over Kashmir. The Mujahideens or terrorists trained by Pakistan military establishment later initiated a war against the Western world too, which then acknowledged Pakistan's state-sponsored terrorism and India's struggle to fight this menace.
Innocent civilians of Balochistan continue to bear the brunt of Pakistan's devious agendas as terror attacks and violence is constantly plaguing the province. In a latest attack, a suicide bomb blast in the capital city of Quetta killed at least 10 people and wounded 35 others. Pakistan, that provides safe havens to terrorists on its soil and nurtures them, is using every trick in the book to avoid terror-sponsored tag, but the country seems to have fallen prey to its own evil designs. A report.
Balochistan's capital city bled once again as a suicide bomb attack near a religious rally in the city killed at least 10 people, including 2 police personnel, and wounded 35 others. The terror attack was apparently intended to target a procession taking place at the time of attack along main road in the city of Quetta. According to police, the young suicide bomber was trying to enter the rally, but he blew himself up when police intercepted him near a security barrier.
उस रैली के लिए सिक्योरिटी लगाई गई थी और ये उसका एक आउटर कॉर्डन था जहां ईगल और डिस्ट्रिक्ट पुलिस ने मिलके तो आउटर कॉर्डन लगाया था और इनको एक यंग आदमी बच्चा तकरीबन यंग एज का जो इनकी रिपोर्ट के मुताबिक वो आया और उसको इन्होंने रोका और वो उसकी सिचुएशन ऐसी थी कि वो उसने रुकने की बजाय आगे जाने की कोशिश की, तो इसको उन्होंने स्ट्रगल करके तो उसको इन्होंने रोका, गिराया और गिरते ही उसने अपने आप को वो डिटोनेट कर लिया, जिससे हमारे भी दो बंदे वो जो जिन्होंने रोका पुलिस के ईगल के वो शहीद हुए।
Such horrific attacks are not only affecting the daily lives of people, but are also adversely impacting the sports activities in the country. The attack in Pakistan comes at a time when the country is working hard to revive the game of cricket inside its territory. Pakistan was banned from hosting any match at home for nearly a decade in the wake of the barbaric attack on Sri Lankan team in 2009 in Lahore that left 8 people dead and injured 7 Sri Lankan players and staff. The latest bomb blast has once again exposed the grim picture of tenuous security situation in Pakistan.
But for a long time, international cricket was not played in Pakistan. Pakistan would play its tests, its so-called home tests, on neutral venues like the United Arab Emirates. Why was this? Because you know, security situation in Pakistan got so bad that the Sri Lankan team was actually attacked. They were subject to attack and they escaped very narrowly with their lives. So when attacks of this happen, they remind the rest of the world that the security situation in Pakistan is extremely bad, and foreign tourists would be and visiting teams would be advised to stay away from Pakistan.
Terrorists have been targeting Quetta and other places in Balochistan for past several decades. This ability of terrorists to breach security in the country and attack with ferocity has startled the world. They have been doing so at the commands of Pakistan military and ISI that not only provide resources and funds for terror proliferation, but also a political patronage to allow Tehrik-e-Taliban Pakistan and Islamic State terror groups to unleash their devious strategies in their own style.
Pakistan has looted Balochistan for its resources and in return has spent practically nothing in Balochistan. So Pakistan derives much of its wealth from Balochistan, and yet the Baloch people are possibly the poorest in Pakistan. Under these circumstances, it is only natural that people will be resentful, and given the enormous, the terrible history of human rights atrocities by the Pakistanis in Balochistan, obviously there is going to be some reaction. Instead of the Pakistanis calling for talks, calling for dialogues, so that people who are forced to take up arms actually lay out their arms, Pakistan has only increased the level of the intensity of its atrocities. So what Pakistan is doing in Balochistan is very foolishly making things even worse for itself.
This insensitivity of Pakistan towards the locals of Balochistan, religious minorities, or indeed human life isn't anything new. Baloch nationalists are frequently targeted by Pakistani security forces across the province. They have been struggling for an independent state since 1948 and are consistently muzzled or shot down at their slightest protest against the administration. The recurring terror attacks in the mineral-rich province expose Pakistan military and its notorious inter-service intelligence agency's deadly plans for the region.
Pakistan's tireless campaign of unleashing terror inside Indian territory is being given a befitting reply by Indian forces. Recently, proactive Indian defense successfully eliminated the terrorists belonging to Pakistan-backed terrorist group Hizbul Mujahideen. And it's not a one-off breakthrough, but the forces have been successful in busting all the nefarious anti-India plots hatched in the corridors of Islamabad and Rawalpindi. A report.
In a major setback to Islamabad, Indian security forces recently gunned down 3 terrorists of Hizbul Mujahideen, a Pakistan-backed terror group including a self-styled commander of the outfit, Jahangir Ahmed Wani, who had taken over the command of the outfit in the area after the killing of Hammad Khan, the former commander of the terror group. Based on specific inputs about terrorists hiding in the targeted area of the district, a search operation was launched during which terrorists fired upon the security forces, triggering an encounter.
कामयाब ऑपरेशन शेराबाद तराल में हुआ जिसमें हिजबुल मुजाहिदीन के तीन टेररिस्ट मारे गए. हमाद खान के उस एरिया में मारे जाने के बाद जो सबसे खतरनाक टेररिस्ट वहां पर ऑपरेट कर रहा था और जिसने हिजबुल मुजाहिदीन की उस जगह में कमांड ली थी जहांगीर, वो भी इसमें शामिल है. और उसके साथ दूसरा जो राजा मकबूल और तीसरा सदात.
इंडियन आर्म फोर्स ऑफ लेट हैव इंटेंसिफाइड देयर एफर्ट्स टू डेसिमेट टेररिस्ट फ्रॉम द वैली. मेजर ऑपरेशंस आर बीइंग कैरिड आउट वेयर 23 टेररिस्ट हैव बीन एलिमिनेटेड इन वेरियस एनकाउंटर्स सिंस लास्ट मंथ, व्हाइल अ नंबर ऑफ ओवरग्राउंड वर्कर्स हु वर फैसिलिटेटिंग दीस टेररिस्ट इन द वैली have been apprehended.
कुल मिला के अभी तक जो 2020 का एंटी टेररिस्ट ऑपरेशंस का सिलसिला है इसमें 10 के करीब कामयाब ऑपरेशन हुए जिसमें 2 ऑपरेशन जम्मू में हुए और 8 ऑपरेशन हमारे यहाँ कश्मीर में हुए. दोनों जगह पे मिलाकर के 19 टेररिस्ट यहाँ पर न्यूट्रलाइज किए गए कश्मीर में और 4 टेररिस्ट जो हैं वो जम्मू रीजन में मारे गए. इसके अलावा जो OGW जो इनका सपोर्ट स्ट्रक्चर है जो इनको मदद करते हैं इनकी रोजमर्रा के काम कार्रवाई में, 40 के करीब वो लोग भी पकड़े गए हैं.
ओवर द पास्ट फ्यू डेज पाकिस्तान हैज इंटेंसिफाइड इट्स एफर्ट्स एट इंक्रीजिंग द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ टेररिस्ट इन लॉन्च पैड्स अलोंग द लाइन ऑफ कंट्रोल. These terrorists are always on a lookout to infiltrate into Kashmir, which is facilitated by constant unprovoked ceasefire violations by Pakistan Army. These constant ceasefire violations and shelling by Pakistan has compelled civilians in the region to live under an atmosphere of constant fear and terror.
रात को जैसे ही 8 बजते हैं, 8 बजे शुरू हो जाती है गोलाबारी, सुबह 6 बजे तक गोलाबारी चलती रहती है. हाँ जी, बहुत बुरा हालात है जी यहाँ. देखो ये जो टूटे हुए छप्पर है हमारे पास, कहाँ जाएंगे रात को.
पाकिस्तान इज लिविंग नो स्टोन अनटर्न्ड टू इन्फिल्ट्रेट टेररिस्ट इनटू इंडियन टेरिटरी टू कैरी आउट अटैक्स इन द रीजन. डिस्पाइट इट्स इंटरनल इनस्टेबिलिटी, फेलिंग इकोनॉमी एंड इंटरनेशनल आइसोलेशन, पाकिस्तान डज नॉट कॉम्प्रोमाइज व्हेन इट कम्स टू फंडिंग टेररिस्ट. These terrorist attacks are meant not only to cause large-scale damage to life and property, but also to create an atmosphere of fear and terror among the people of Jammu and Kashmir. However, all of its vicious attempts have been successfully thwarted by vigilant Indian forces.
And with that, we come to the end of this edition of Newsweek South Asia. We will be back next week with more news, views and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@anin.com. This is Shreya Vijay signing off on the behalf of entire production team of Newsweek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.